There are two major characteristics of substances which allow them to be sticky: their ability to form intramolecular chemical bonds and their intermolecular interactions. Glues take advantage of both, helping them achieve a permanent stick. But it's the more temporary intermolecular interactions that will be the focus of this video. You've almost certainly seen how two magnets can attract each other, North Pole to South Pole. Many molecules can behave in an analogous way. In water, for example, oxygen loves electrons and hogs them for itself, while only leaving a little for the less greedy hydrogens. This creates a slight charge imbalance, which allows molecules to interact like little magnets, positive to negative. Intermolecular forces such as these are the basis for stickiness. The forces exist on a spectrum, depending on the characteristics of the molecules in question. Ones like water are considered very polar, with the differing atomic greediness for electrons creating a relatively powerful charge imbalance, leading to a stronger intermolecular interaction. Molecules like hydrocarbons share electrons equally, and any weak interactions between them are product of momentary imbalances in electron distribution. Sugars like those found in honey are in some ways water on steroids. Each molecule has multiple oxygen-hydrogen bonds, which allows it to take advantage of the stronger intermolecular forces multiple times over. This makes it sticky to itself, or viscous, and also sticky to other surfaces like your hand. Though molecules relying on weak intermolecular interactions may seem at a disadvantage, they can take advantage of sheer numbers to be sticky. If you put your hand up against the wall, you might seem like you're making good contact, but in reality there are very few contact points, which is why it won't stick. Contrast this to a gecko's foot, with nanohairs that fill in the gaps and increase the surface area. The increased contact allows for more intermolecular forces, and therefore enough stickiness to climb a wall. In fact, some geckos have been reported to be able to hold up to 80 pounds. A sticky note works in a similar way, with microspheres on its surface that when pressed have a large surface and allow it to stick. And believe it or not, even a sticky note can hold a pound or two. Both a gecko's foot and a sticky note have to be strong enough to hold weight, but weak enough to unstick and move. The key to this balance is peeling. You don't pull a sticky note to remove it, you peel it, and a gecko does the same with its foot. Peeling isolates smaller groups of interactions, which can be easily overcome, rather than facing their collective strength. Thanks for watching this video, and be sure to like it, share it, and subscribe to Everyday Elements.